Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of binary trees, guys. Okay, yes. So in the last lecture, we discussed with the introduction about trees, right? Yes. So in this lecture, let us go through the binary trees. So basically, what is a binary, guys? So binary means two, right? So 0 and 1 binary language we know, right? So it is indirectly showcasing that 2 is the number, right? Yes. Okay, so basically binary tree is nothing but a node contains at most maximum of 2 children, that's it. So any tree you draw, every node should have maximum of 2 children. If it is having more than 2 children, it is not a binary tree, a simple thing. Got it? Yes. So is this node having more than 2? No. Hence, it is a binary tree. Is this node having more than 2? No. Is this node having more than 2? No. Is this node having more than 2? No. Hence, it is a binary tree. Similarly, this node is having more than 2. It is not a binary tree. All nodes are not having more than 2. Binary tree. All nodes are not having more than 2. Not binary tree. One node is having more than 2. That is not binary tree. Got it? Yes. So now you can differentiate what is binary tree and what is not binary tree. Right? Yes. Okay. So one of the most important point that you should remember is all binary trees are trees, but all trees are not binary trees. Remember that, guys. Okay. Yes. So this could be a true or false statement in our gate examination. So that is the reason why I'm just pointing it out. Okay. Yes. Okay. So two popular structures, okay, of binary trees are left skewed and right skewed, guys. Okay. The reason why I am saying them right here and here itself is because most of the previous year question papers will have this concept, guys. Left skewed and right skewed. Okay, we'll be discussing one example in this lecture. Don't worry. Okay, yes. So if all the elements are on the left side, that is nothing but left skewed. And if all the elements are on right side, right skewed. Five elements, five on to left, right to right. Got it? Yes. So now your question will be, okay, so now we got some idea. Okay, but exactly how these trees are stored in the memory. So you might have that doubt, right? Yes. So let us discuss the representation of trees. Okay. Yes. Sorry for that. Okay. So representation of tree in memory. Okay. So representation could be done in two different ways, guys. So the first way is nothing but using arrays, and the second one is nothing but using linked list. Okay. Okay. So sequence representation is nothing but using arrays. Okay, so basically the array representation will look in this way, guys. Okay, so I am sure that you did not get that much idea just by observing, right? Yes. So let me explain you with an example. Okay. Yes. Okay, so any tree diagram, so let me draw a proper tree. Okay, so if you want to store this in array, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So in that exact order only it will store, guys. Okay. Yes. So in this way. So basically now you got an idea, right? So basically this will be the first location, second, third, fourth, five, six, seven. So basically here we are having all elements. It's okay. But what if we are having a tree in this way? 2, 3, 4, 5. So the thing here is you should remember the slots are something like fixed, guys. So the first one will take here, the second one will take here, okay, the third one will take here, the fourth one will take here. Here the fifth one is not there, right? So that is the reason why fifth slot is left empty, and sixth one is also not there, hence the sixth slot will also left empty, and the seventh slot will be filled with 5. Got it? Yes. So in this way the array representation will be done, guys. So by observation only you will be saying that, okay, so then there will be a huge wastage of slots, right? The answer is yes, you're right, there will be a wastage of slots using the normal array representation. So that is the reason why we use linked list representation. So the exact one is written here, guys. Okay. Yes. Okay, so the linked list representation. Okay, so one more thing is that if you want to get the address of ith element, so the left child will be at 2i, guys. So if you want to check it, you can check it here. Okay, so let me write down the indexes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, remember one more thing, always whenever you are trying to calculate the indexes, start from 1, guys. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, yes. So once you wrote them, so of ith index, so assume that I want to calculate the thirds right child. Okay, so third's right or left child. Okay, so third. So for I equal to 3, what will be the left child, guys? So left child is nothing but 3 into 2, guys. That is nothing but the formula is a 2i. Okay, that is a 6. At the sixth location, you will be having the, okay, at the sixth location, you will be having the left child. So that is empty, right? Yes. Similarly, right child at 3 into 2 plus 1. That is nothing but 2i plus 1. Got it? Yes. So that will be 7. So at 7, we are having the 5. So that is what it is written here. Got it? Yes. So using that simple formula, you can solve it, guys. And remember, 1i should be greater than 0 always. Okay? Yes. Okay. So I think now you got the disadvantage of the link of the normal array structure, right? So there will be a wastage of space. Okay. So how you are going to store it there if there is a wastage of space using that method? Okay. So the best method to store them is nothing but using a linked list, guys. So I think you know, right? So we can use a doubly linked list. So data and left child and right child. So using this structure, you can draw the tree, right? So if you want me to draw that exact tree, just give me a second. I'll be taking a piece of paper. Okay. So you want me to draw this exact tree, right? Yes. So let me draw it. On left, we are having a 2. For this left, we are having a 4. Okay. Here we are having a 3. And for this left, we are having 5. Got it? Yes. So this is the tree structure. Got it? There is no wastage of space, no need of empty slots and all those things. So here we are indirectly saving some space, you can say. Got it? Yes. And this implementation will completely depend on the requirement, guys. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about the representation, right? Yes. So now let us go through a previous year question. So the question is in this way. So he gave the value of n is a 7. The total number of nodes are 15. Okay. And he is asking the maximum and minimum height of the tree. So this is a GATE 2017 question, guys. You can say it is a recent question. Okay. Yes. So how many nodes we are having, guys? In total 15. Okay. So if there is a one node here, the maximum could be 2. Okay. So here again 2. Again a 2. How many are done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 are done. So we can continue even. We want 15, right? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3. So 3 levels if we want the minimum value. So what is maximum value? So for maximum value, if you recall, so we are having left skewed and right skewed trees, guys. Right? Yes. So those trees could be used here. Okay, so basically if you understand the logic, so it will be having 15 elements, but the first level one will be level 0. So at the end we will be having level 14, right? Hence the answer will be 14 and 3 or 3 and 14 based on the question. So maximum is, okay, sorry, my bad. Maximum is 14 and minimum is 3. Got it?
Yes.
Okay, and one more thing that you should remember is in some questions they can inform us to take the root as height has 1. So if you recall, here I took the root height as a 0, right? So in some questions, they could directly say you to take the root height as a 1, guys. So that also you should remember, okay? Yes. In simple words, you can say maximum height is nothing but, okay, that is n minus 1. So if there is a maximum height, if you want to calculate the maximum height, you can do it by n minus 1. Just to do n minus 1, you'll be getting the maximum height. That's it. So 15 minus 1 is 14. Got it? Yes. Similarly, for minimum height, we are having a formula, guys. So n is equals to 2 power h plus 1 minus 1. So basically, by substituting h values, you can identify the n value. So whenever it is near to 15, you will be stopping there. Got it? Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea with respect to this height binary tree basics, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us discuss about the traversals in binary tree. Okay? Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.